Thanks so much, Rich, and thanks so much, Mayor Weaver. It is great to be here, and it is great to see all of you. You know, as I was driving here today from the airport, I was thinking about the fact that I first came to Flint almost a year ago. A year ago next week, President Obama signed the Emergency Declaration, committing federal resources to provide help here in Flint, and asking me to lead the federal response. It has been an incredible year. You know, when you come every week, it's hard to see progress, and when you look back over the year, it is amazing just to think about the amount of progress that has been made. It has been such an honor for me to be able to serve this role and to get to know and work with and help this community. You know, when we began, with something as straightforward as FEMA buying millions of miles of water and streaming, turned into a really full-blown response to the problem, making sure everybody had the safe drinking water, ultimately fixing the water system, and that's in progress, and mitigating the impacts of lead on this community, especially for children. But when I got there, things were really, really different than they were now. When I got here, there was a community that was full here in the valley and trust. It was palpable the moment it happened. When I got here, the officials who were supposed to be taking care of us, the officials from the city, from the state, from the federal government, wouldn't talk to each other. They wouldn't get in the same room with one another. And now what you see is you see them sitting side by side, you see them all on the stage together. You see federal, state, and local partners from all different parts of government together with the community, with the Flint Cares community, the public health community, the medical community, and citizens of Flint all working together to move forward. And it has just been such an inspiration. And I want to congratulate all of you. I never imagined a year ago that I would see this day. I think you know that we have all done so much. We've learned about, you know, lead water, lead pipes, how to fix water systems. We've learned about the important role of healthcare and mental health in the lives of children and families and adults. And we've made enormous progress, as you know, expanding healthcare, nutrition, early education. Frankly, stuff that every community in this country ought to have. Not just Flint, but I'm incredibly grateful and honored that we've been able to really step it up in the ways we have been able to do in Flint. And now there are numerous opportunities for recovery. As you know, Congress has approved $100 million for pipe replacement and recovery. That was great news. This fall, HHS agreed to provide another $120 million over 5 years to coordinate and target the lead maintenance services, including pipe replacement in the homes of children in Fredericksburg. The Department of Labor has helped make funds available for grants and job development. Flint is moving forward in many important ways. The Department of Transportation has stepped up in big ways. FEMA has provided a fire emergency response, safer grant, mental health funding in this community, and all of these resources remain available, and you can read about them on Flint Cares. Flint Cares has formed and has stepped up, and really, you always want an emergency response to see a community get to the point where it can take care of itself. And this community has been phenomenal. I've seen a lot of disasters in my past few years. I'm not sure I have seen a community with this inner strength, this resolve, and this resilience, and it's amazing. I will tell you that a year ago, I never could have imagined that we would have a data summit. First of all, we didn't have any data. Secondly, my first day, I was based on very little data. I had to do something that was really hard. I had to stand up in front of many of you and say, I'm not really sure it's safe to drink from water from the filter because the filters aren't rated for the levels of lead. Here, I had to get the mayor out of the secret to join me in this. My goodness, how far we have come. Here we are, openly looking at data, debating what it means, sharing. growing, and let us also prosper together. And that has been just fantastic, everybody working together. The willingness to find common ground here in Flint, in my mind, is a model of really, not only for us, but frankly, I think and I hope it can become a model of healing for our nation. Yes, there will be ongoing challenges with the water system and other aspects of recovery. But you guys are amazing, strong, and resilient. So now, it's really time for me to say goodbye to you. It's my last trip to Flint. I end my job with the Obama administration this weekend. But I want to assure you that the federal government, my colleagues at EPA, CDC, the rest of HHS, those career federal officials who have been at this all along, will be here, they will continue to watch, they will continue to monitor, they will continue to test, they will continue to look at data and share information like this. We're all in it for the long haul, they are in it for the long haul, and they are not going anywhere. I'll confess, as I leave, this is pretty bittersweet. I've gotten really attached to this community. I've really gotten attached to those people. I want to say thank you for the opportunity to serve and to serve with you. I leave with